I'm Dr. Harold Burstein, a medical oncologist in the Breast Oncology Center at Dana-Farber. And this is a series where we're talking about terms that breast cancer patients might encounter. The term we're speaking of in this video is neoadjuvant therapy. Now, for many patients who are diagnosed with breast cancer, the first step in their management is surgery to remove the tumor. And then they often get what we call adjuvant treatment, which is drug therapy given after surgery to help mop up any microscopic flecks of cancer that might have snuck away from the breast or chest area and pose a risk of recurrence. With neoadjuvant therapy, we flip the sequence. So instead of having surgery first and then drug treatment, we offer drug therapy first and then surgery. And we do that for several very specific reasons. First, giving the drug therapy first can allow for a lesser operation or lesser surgery down the road for the patient. If the drug treatment shrinks the tumor, a woman who might have needed a mastectomy at baseline might be able to have breast-conserving surgery, for instance. Similarly, if there's cancer in the lymph nodes in the armpit, by shrinking those down, the surgeon might be able to do a lesser operation in the armpit or the axilla, a so-called sentinel lymph node biopsy, instead of a more extensive, complete axillary dissection. Secondly, we learn something from the extent of the response to treatment. If the cancer shrinks a lot or disappears entirely, then that patient has a better long-term prognosis than in someone where the drug therapy proves less effective. That also allows us to tailor or individualize the drug treatment on the backside after the surgery. Women who have dramatic responses up front often need less treatment on the backside. And by contrast, a patient who has residual tumor despite the neoadjuvant therapy might benefit from switching gears and trying a different approach after the surgery is completed. Finally, of course, neoadjuvant treatment goes everywhere in the body, and so if there is any of that same microscopic deposit of cancer somewhere, neoadjuvant drug therapy allows us to go after it. For those reasons, neoadjuvant therapy has become our preferred approach to many patients who present with breast cancer, especially those who have larger tumors in the breast or known lymph node involvement. And we, of course, use different types of drug treatment depending on the diagnosis type of breast cancer. For HER2-positive breast cancers, we typically give chemotherapy paired with anti-HER2 drugs like trastuzumab or pertuzumab. For triple-negative breast cancers, we typically give chemotherapy with an immune checkpoint inhibitor like pembrolizumab. And for ER-positive breast cancers, we sometimes give chemotherapy, and sometimes we even give upfront or neoadjuvant endocrine treatment to help optimize the outcomes. So neoadjuvant therapy has really emerged as an important tool for patients who present with stage 2 or 3 breast cancer, where we want to shrink the tumor ahead of surgery while still providing very effective medicines to control the cancer everywhere in the body.